Congratulations, both of you, on what I would describe as a extended Twilight Zone episode. It is so much fun to watch. I'm going to start with Sabrina. Sabrina, we're both living in the same city almost.
Really? Where are you from?
I'm from LA, but I live in Eagle Mountain, Utah.
Wow, just right over, yep, right over the freeway.
Yep, just right there. Tell me a little bit about getting this role. Was there a big audition for it?
You know, it was definitely in the middle of the pandemic. So at that point, it was all self-taped. So I actually was able to tape from Utah and send it in. And luckily was able to get a call back, and we did that through Zoom. And yeah, it was very untraditional way of auditioning, but ended up working out for me. So I can't complain.
What about the role called to you? What about it did you go, wow, I got to do this?
I really loved how different she was from who I am in my day-to-day life. I loved the idea of playing someone so out there, so fun, so chaotic.
Mm-hmm.
And as soon as I read the script, I loved her immediately and was all in, ready to do it.
Isaac, you have worked with some really, really great actors in the past, and a few of them are my friend. Michael Dorn, Torrin Nemec, are dear friends of mine. And in this film, you've managed to get Chris Elliott and Phil Hendry, two of the funniest people in the world, to kind of do dramatic parts.
No, actually, you know, when you talk about the Shadow Hours, right? The guys you mentioned, and over there also, like if you think about Peter Green, who always plays like bad guys, and I, you know, well, it's fun to cast people against the grain, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, as far as you know, Chris Elliott, you know, it was he never done that role, so he didn't feel very comfortable. So we really, but he did a great job, because the thing is, he has to, in the beginning of the film, he has to be menacing. It has to be like the strong guy, the guy you fear. And he's totally not that in all his other roles, you know what I mean? So so it was cast against the grain, but later on in the movie, you can see the humor coming out as far as his character, yeah.
Sabrina, were you allowed to go off script a little and ad-lib?
Yeah, a little bit. We had fun, you know. Luckily, Isaac had such a specific vision for Lila, so it was really easy for when I was kind of struggling with finding her, that he was able to really help me find her and get that figured out. And so we messed around a little bit with her lines here and there, but for the most part, I feel like she was written so well in the script that I was able to just bring that to life.
I want to also talk to you, Isaac, about, you know, where you shot, because that certainly is a character in the film. And I know you shot in California, but boy, it's, you brought me something new, and I'm, you know, basically a Californian. And I looked at this set and this scenery, and I said, I don't know where that is. Is that Lompoc? Is that, you did such a great job in bringing us this town of Readville.
Okay. So this is an interesting question. You know, we really did, we scouted for months, and it's really, and we wanted a town that was like stuck in time, right? That is like, and finally we found this place called Fillmore, which is like just, Fillmore, you know where it is? It's Ventura County, which is
sure.
Like, what is it? Like 45 minutes away from the zone.
Near Calabasas.
You know, so yeah, from the zone is really La Cienega. I think La Cienega and Beverly is the center. And the zone is, I don't remember, 35 miles. That was like 45. So we got like a little problem with the actors as far as like the time, traveling time. So this town was like, I mentioned it in a previous interview. This is like a frozen town. They shoot a lot there, actually. Hollywood shoots a lot there. There's a lot of trains there. And a lot of, whenever they want a train scene, that's where they go. I mentioned in a previous interview, it was really hard to shoot this. They gave us a lot of problems. And we were very happy to burn it down in the end. So
that must have been the rap party.
Yeah, right.
Sabrina, what do you look for in roles? Do you look for people that are like you or totally opposite of you?
Kind of a little bit of both. It depends. I've played roles where the character is so similar to me, it feels like they take the character right out of my past. And then this role was completely opposite of me. And so I think it's mostly roles that I feel drawn to when I read the script, or roles that I feel like I can see come to life. And this was luckily one of those, and I was really excited to play Lila.
Isaac, in putting this together, you're also the co-writer of the film, and directing it. I mean, directing a thriller is different than directing a comedy or anything else because your camera has to be at a certain level. You've got to use the light and shadow, I think, and you did such a great job in this.
Yeah, thank you. It is difficult to do a thriller with a whimsical comedy angle to it. It's very difficult, and and basically it's really I worked on the screenplay for many years, and to integrate this into, without hurting the flow of the main plot and keeping it light and whimsical. And part of it was also the music, Chet Tolliver, the composer. I told him I wanted the music like Nino Rota, that wrote the music for Fellini. Actually, he's known in America because he wrote the music, the score for Godfather, But he wrote a lot of whimsical things with Fellini, and with Chet Tolliver, we really worked hard to bring the, because the music is the score really tells you how to feel about a certain theme in general, you know what I mean? So I think that was part, a big part of it, to keep it light and to keep it moving. And I love the score there, where it's kind of a motif of in his subconscious of stealing the diamond, specific motif that when Sabrina says big blue diamond, and then this music creeps in, it was not easy thing to do. It really was not easy to balance all those elements.
But it paid off in spades. This is just a fun film to watch. It's an edge of your seat thriller. It's a little creepy too because of those elements. But Sabrina, what do you think audiences are going to take away from watching Welcome to Redville?
I hope they just have fun. I hope that they enjoy it. I think there's so much passion that was put into the project that I hope it really bleeds through, and they see the hard work that was put into it. Isaac obviously put so much passion and work into it, so I really hope it's able to come to life for him and the way he sees it. And we love the film, so we enjoyed watching it. We hope that viewers also enjoy it and just, have a wild ride like we did, and are able to have fun with it.
Yeah, I had fun watching it. It is just really takes me back to like the 60s and 70s. Such a great premise, and everybody did so well. Even your background people, your extras were incredible.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate it. I appreciate that. It's interesting what you said, because it's a kind of neoclassical film. The story, it's classical storytelling, and then you're going to bring something more modern, more into it. So I really appreciate what you're saying. Absolutely.
Thank you guys so much and have a great day. Sabrina, we'll catch up in Utah sometime.
Yes, I love that. Thank you so much.